Hi, this is JP from Northern Lights Over Arkham. This time, in the Mad Titan Shadow playthroughs, we are playing the fourth scenario in the box, and it is Hela. And this time we are playing it with Spectrum, aka Monica Rambeau. Hela is an interesting villain because you can't straight off defeat Hela. Hela has only 8 health on a true solo playthrough. But the trick is that we need to save Odin from Odin's torment, or Odin's prison, whatever you want to call it. And to do so, we have to deal with these side schemes. And before we can deal with the side schemes, we need to deal with the guardians that are guarding the side schemes. So I will talk a bit more about the side schemes and how they function when we get started, but this first one is quite simple. It's a acceleration token, and when you defeat it, the first player reveals the next one, which is Gjallar Bru, and then the Guardian Scourge, and puts them into play and deal each other player one face down encounter card. So the first player doesn't get an encounter card, but the others would if it would be a multiplayer. And the guardian is all of the guardians have toughness. Then they engage the first player, and we cannot remove threat from the scheme they come with. So that is pretty simple. Hela is scheme one attack villain. But Hela gets plus one scheme and plus one attack and plus two hit points for each side scheme in the victor display. So Hela's health and stats will rise the more we get these side schemes into the victor display. Also, when Hela is defeated, if Odin is not attached to the main scheme, you win the game. So our goal is to free Odin. To do so, we will free Odin once we've defeated three of these side schemes, and then we have to defeat Hela. And yeah, when we manage to defeat Hela or hit Hela enough to remove all of the hit points, the main scheme says that we flip it this to the wounded side. So Hela cannot be defeated. Force response after side scheme is defeated, flip Hela to her mystic side. So we need to maybe not focus on trying to flip Hela before we've defeated all of the side schemes we need to defeat. But that is basically the scenario. I will talk more about the progress of the scenario once we get started. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, well, we are ready to start. The decks are shuffled, so we'll draw our opening hand. We get Captain America, Gamma Blast, Speed of Light, Gamma Blast, Photon Speed, and Power Man. First off, we don't have a lot of ways to play at least Captain America, because we don't have enough resources. We could try to play Power Man, but again, not a good start. I think what we are going to do is we will flip to Hero Mode right away. I will flip to Gamma, so we deal one damage somewhere, deal it to Garm. Next, we will Gamma Blast. I'll use Captain America. The other, I'll use the Power Man. And what do I want to use? I think I'll save the Gamma Blast actually. So I'll use these to play the Gamma Blast, and Change to gamma energy form and deal 7 damage to an enemy. If you were already in gamma energy form, this attack gains overkill. So we overkill 3 damage to Hela. And Garm goes to the victory display. Doesn't affect the game at all anymore, so I'll just put it over here so they are defeated and not in the game anymore. And then I have a couple of other things I can do, so I could actually just try to I think I'm saving the photon speed for next gen to get rid of this, so I will just I will just ward for one and do it over here. That is our turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 5. Another photon speed, Moxie band together, photon speed and gamma blasts. We'll go to the villain phase. We add one threat to the main scheme. Actually two, because we have the acceleration token still in play. Hela attacks. I will take it to the spectrum, so Hela is 1 plus 0, so 1 plus 1 is 2, and if damage from this attack defeats an ally, place a threat on the main scheme. Well, it didn't, so we'll just take 2 damage. We'll get an encounter card. It is Hela's cloak attached to Hela. Hela gains stalwart, and means that we can't stun or confuse Hela, and I'll use this token to reference the stalwart, so we can't stun or confuse Hela. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see. I really don't like these band together cards when I don't have any allies, so this turn I think I will just play the photon speed. So we'll change to photon. We get to remove one threat from a scheme. And I'm using the Moxie and photon speed to do it. And we can remove 4 threat from a scheme, and I wasn't in a photon form, so can't ignore those crisis icons, but there are none. So we remove this, and we defeat this, so we will reveal Yaller, Brew and Scourge. We get these two, so Scourge and Yaller Brew is hinder 1, victory 3 when defeated. The first player reveals Hull of Nastrond and Nidhogg and puts them into play. Deal each other player 1 face on the card, and it gives an additional boost icon. So we really want to try and get rid of that one also fast. And Scourge. Scourge is a 1 scheme, 3 attack minion. 5 health, toughness, victory 3. Scourge engages the first player. Scourge attacks gain piercing. Threat cannot be removed from Yaller Brew. So we need to defeat Scourge. So that is why I'm keeping the Gamma Blast in hand. And I think I will flip to. Oh no, before that, I will just. Ward for 1 here, flip to Alter Ego, and draw back up to 6. We get Avengers Mansion, Photon Speed, Pulsar Shield, Kalu, Gamma Blast, and we still have. Actually, I will discard the. Before we mulligan, I'll discard this because I forgot I had it in hand, and I'll draw Ready to Rumble, so at least we can spend that card now. Okay, we'll go to the villain phase. This went away. We'll also mark that Hela has plus 1 scheme and plus 1 part, this goes this side. So these are just to represent the amount of side schemes in the discard. Help me keep track of Hela's stats. Okay, we'll go to the villain phase, so we add a threat to the main scheme. Hela schemes for 2 plus 1 plus 1 so 4. This guy schemes for 1, so total of 5. And counter card for this turn is, and it is frozen. That's your identity. That's identity cannot ready. Alter ego action spent. Energy and physical resource, discard this card. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So, let's see. This is an alter ego action, so we need to make a decision now. We want to get rid of it. I feel that we don't need to get rid of it yet, so just ignore it for now. I'm aiming to play... Well, I could play Kalu, because it draws us an event, which you can use as a resource, so we still have enough. So I'm using Avengers Tower and Photon Speed to play Kalu. So after Kalu enters play, search the top 5 cards of your deck for an event, add that event to your hand, shuffle your deck. And we get Speed of Light, which is an event. Actually, I'm picking the mass attack because I will be discarding it as a resource, so I don't have allies to play, and this requires the exhaust 3 allies, so it can't even use it. It's a really weak card, in my opinion, for this. It should be up to exhaust up to 3 allies to control the Terra trait, so you can use it even with the 1 ally, but it is what it is. We'll flip. I'm just healing, because why not? We'll flip, and I'll pick Gamma. So we will ping Scourge for 1 damage. Then I will play Gamma Blast using 3. We deal 5 here and 2 to Hela. Oh yeah, and Hela got plus 1, so 6. So Hela is down to 4. I forgot to add the plus 2 from that, so actually it's up to 5. Good thing I know it is now. So we have the correct health total. So Scourge is defeated and we are able to thwart the side scheme later. And Kalu actually... Kalu will actually... Nothing. So, oh yeah, we can't ready because we have the frozen. Go back up to 5. Avengers Mansion, Band Together, Mighty Avengers, Gamma Blast, and Rare, ready to rumble. So, not use it really in need of the Gamma Blast, but we'll probably play the Avengers Mansion or something next turn. So, that is the hero phase. Let's go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat to the main scheme. Hela attacks, I'll take it to the Spectrum. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Damage. Counter card is assault. I think we just have to use Kalu for this one. So okay, so that defeats ally, so we place 2 threat to the main scheme, so not looking really good. So we're at 9 of 18, so halfway losing to threat, but it is what it is. That is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Now we can't play the Avengers Mansion, so that is unfortunate. Well, this sucks. I can't really do anything now because of the frozen and I lost Kalu. We could just hit Hela to get rid of the cloak and buy us some time. Yeah, we'll do that. So we'll gamma blast the Hela. Using these three, we can't use the band together, unfortunately. So we deal 7 here. Hela flips. Hela cannot be defeated. Force respawn. Okay, so force respawns after the side scheme is defeated. Flip Hela to her mystic side, and Odin's torment reads. When Hela would be defeated, if Odin is attached to this scheme, discard its attachment from Hela and flip her to her wounded side instead. So we discard the cloak. Hela loses stalwart. And we'll just discard this and go to villain phase, so we'll draw back up to 5. So Hela loses also these boosts. So we have energy duplication, blue marvel, mass attack, ready to rumble, and energy duplication. We'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat to the main scheme. Hela schemes for 0 plus 1 plus 0, so 1. Encounter card is Night Sword, attacks Hela. Hela's attack gain piercing and plus 1 attack, so that is okay at this point. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Somehow I feel like we're not gonna win this, because all of the thwarting cards went in the start of the game, so we are treading water. So I think what I'm able to do at this point is to just set up these energy duplications. So we'll play 1, we'll use that and blue marvel to play the second one. And that is basically it, so we're ready up. Draw back up to 5. Could have played blue marvel, but I feel like this will boost our gameplay later, and we can get rid of the frozen when we next time go to alter ego. So we get speed of light, mighty Avengers, genius, speed of light, mighty Avengers. So nothing good. Okay, well, we'll go to the villain phase. We add first I'll change these to 11, so we add 1 threat. Hela schemes for what? Hela attacks, actually. I think I messed up and schemed last turn. Yeah, I think I misplayed there, but it is what it is, I'm not going back anymore. So Hela attacks for 0 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, so 1, 2, 3 plus if the villain is attacking and it is attacking, deals damage, stun that character, so we're stunned. We take 3. Encounter card is lost control. You cannot change energy forms. Alter ego, action. Exhaust Monica Rambeau, remove loss of control from the game, and I can't exhaust because... Oh, crap, this is so bad. Oh well, that is the villain phase. Let's see what we can do in the next hero phase. Okay, well, the next hero phase is here, and we will just flip to Alter Ego. I'll use these to get rid of the frozen. I will then let these go away. I'll then play Mighty Avengers. And we'll go to hero phase, villain phase. So we'll keep the speed of lights. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more cores. We get strength, pulsar shield, band together, energy, moxie, and speed of light. So again, the band together is so bad. I hate that resource card. If you don't spam allies, it's a pretty useless card. But yeah, let's go to the villain phase. We add one threat. We might lose the game here, but we'll see. So Hela schemes for 0 plus 1. So 1 plus 2 is 3. So we're at 16. 2 away from getting defeated. Encounter card is Shadows of the Past. Well, of course it is. So we get Radioactive Man. We get Reactor Meltdown. We shuffle the Sap Powers and Radioactive Blasts into the counter deck. So I think this is the start of the end. And we'll just try to see what we can do. So after Radioactive Man activates against you, deal 1 damage to each character you control. So we should try to get rid of the Radioactive Man as fast as possible, but I think the game is nearly over anyway. On top of that, we have the crisis icon from Reactor Meltdown. When defeated, deal 1 damage to each friendly character in play. So everything is looking bad. We only have 3 health left, and we have to exhaust this for this so that we can't even heal. Okay, well, let's see if the game ends on next turn. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, well, nothing to play, absolutely nothing. We'll flip. Oh yeah, we are exhausted to get rid of the lost control. And this goes out from the game. We'll flip to hero. He can't even attack. So we'll go to Photon. One from here. Speed of light. We'll go to Pulsar. Heal 1 damage from here. I'll actually mark this so we probably have plus 2 defense. And we'll use Moxie. So we have plus 1 to the end of the round. Just add it from that. We'll ready, and I'll discard the band together. I will draw back up to 5. White Tiger and Blade. Well, you are late. We are nearly lost here. We'll go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. Hela attacks. I will defend. We take 1 plus 1 is 3 damage, minus, well, we defend it all, we take no damage. Radioactive Man hits us for 1, and we'll take 1 damage to each character we control, so that is that. Encounter card is Sap Power, attached to your identity. Force response after your turn ends, take 1 damage. Alter Ego action, spend 2 energy resources, discard this card, so yeah. Okay, well, that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, well, we still have a slight chance to continue the game a bit further. Well, we are at 17 of 18 threat, So we need to first get rid of this, then we need to... Oh yeah, I forgot I had the pulsar shield in hand, so... No, I'm not playing it. So we are playing Blade. We'll play White Tiger. We'll save this for Blade. So White Tiger, after you play White Tiger from your hand, draw X cards to a maximum of 3, where X is equal to the villain's stage number. If the villain has no stage number, draw cards, draw one card. It is a mass attack, totally useless, so we'll use that to activate Blade. So Blade hits 4. We won't hit, so we'll just remove this. Deal 1 damage to each character you control. So this is painful. And White Tiger will thwart for 2 years. Don't lose the threat yet. But I think we're going to lose either way. We ready up. I forgot I'm going to die to the sap power. So we'll die to the sap power. That is it. So I'm not struggling against the tide anymore. So, that was Hela on standard difficulty with the Spectrum prebuilt deck. And I played a practice game before this, and I got to the last side scheme, but this time weren't able to advance from that side scheme because everything went wrong at the minute we got frozen. So yeah, still I really like this scenario. It is a bit similar to the first collector scenario from the Galaxy's Most Wanted box, so I probably will try this again, either with the constructed deck or just try it with Spectrum to see if it's even possible to beat it. But this was basically all of the mechanics of the game, so we flipped Hela, and if we would have actually we defeated a side scheme, so this would flip here now. So yeah, we basically saw all of the mechanics that are available for this scenario. So hope you guys like this playthrough. Next up we have the final scenario from the Mad Titan Shadow box. So next up will be Loki, and probably I will play with Adam Warlock, as now I played with Spectrum. So look forward to that playthrough. Thanks for watching, and until next time.